Over the last century, the size of the average American home has been increasing. But is bigger really better? Researchers with the Twin Cities Household Ecosystem Project have found that the larger your home is, the more it impacts the surrounding environment. From carbon emissions to phosphorus runoff, larger houses tend to create larger flows of pollution into our air and water.
We're pretty confident that households really are a major component of urban pollution, whether it's CO2 emissions, nitrogen, or phosphorus. What happens in the household is very important.
These researchers found that a variety of things increase our household footprint. Income, for example, can play a large role. The more money we make as a household, the more we typically spend on travel and consumer goods, which means a bigger carbon footprint. Home size turned out to be another major factor affecting our household footprint. Homes with more square footage require more heating and power, which means more carbon and nitrogen are released into the atmosphere, contributing to global warming.
The size of the home is critical in terms of influencing how much energy that household is going to use ultimately.
Meet Jim and Caleb Wilkins, a father and son team with a unique approach to reducing the environmental footprint of the American home. Their answer? Build smaller houses, much smaller houses.
I'm Jim Wilkins, and I'm the entrepreneur of Tiny Green Cabins. And this is my son, Caleb Wilkins, who works with me on building Tiny Green Cabins. We work together.
There's a lot less material that goes into them, so you're not having to consume as many goods to build what you want. And then with going small, you don't have to use as many engineered products. You can use natural timbers, natural wood.
Everything in the wildflower cabin is certified green. And you can have a tiny house based off subtractive architecture that takes out all the stuff in the house you don't need and leaves you with the stuff you do need. I've got my kitchen set up so it's also my drafting table where I can work at. In the great room that I call it, it's got a workbench that pops down from the wall, folds up. I put my laptop computer there. I can work at it. I can entertain there. I can eat there, all in the same spot. One of the challenges about living in a tiny house, if you're not a neatnik, you got a challenge. But at the same time, it only takes me 15 minutes to go through, vacuum the floor, straighten everything up, and get it organized. It's not claustrophobic to me at all. It's cozy. I crawl up in the loft at the end of the day. It's just magical.
Can a small house make a big impact? Jim and Caleb think so.